opinions and views of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
Naimbag garabi, masantos yung salabid si kayo amin. Mayang gabi sa Dibuk Mindanao, Visayas ug sa Luzon. Dina sa Sambuanga, buenas noches kaninyo. Bismillah, rahmani rahim, assalamu alaikum, rahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Ito po si Erik Espina, ito po ang inyong Republika. Sa buwan po ng Enero, bagamat bagong taon, bagong pag-asa, ito po ang taon din na matatawag natin ay panahon na umiinit na po ang pamumulitika sa ating bansa. Parte po ito ng ating demokrasya, ang pagpapalit ng mga matatawag natin mga muka o ang pagpapanatili ng mga muka na karapat dapat. Sa pagkakataong ito po ay itong ating programa ay kikilalanin natin ang ilan sa mga taong nasa posisyon at ang mga taong nag-iibig na naman na sana'y tangkilikin ninyo sa darating na pambansang halalan. Ikinagagalak pong ipakilala sa inyo isang kapatid, and he is really brother, but although he is also a public servant, the first district congressman of Quezon City, Brother Vincent Bingbong Crisologo. And maganda po dito dahil kasama niya ang kanyang anak. Tama-tama, kasi mamaya tatanong natin yung palaging nadidinig natin yung issue ng dynasty na hindi mamatay-matay. Si Engineer Anthony Peter D. Crisologo, who happens to be also a city councilor. Good evening to both of you.
Good evening, Eric.
Ayan. Okay. Congressman, ito yung matatanong ko sa inyo, no? Kumusta po ang pamumulitika sa Quezon City?
Well, doon, as in any other city, pagdating sa local, it still depends upon the person. Nobody has complete control of the city because alam natin na Quezon City, these are wise voters, no? Mm-hmm. So wala talagang mahawak. So, it's still the people who will make the choice mm-hmm. of who will be their government officials.
Ano ho ang profile, matatawag nating profile ng mga botante sa Quezon City? Mayaman na mayaman, mahirap na mahirap, or ano, nasa gitna lang?
Ang kwanon is we have many depressed areas there, mm-hmm. no, in Quezon City, even in my district. So, mm-hmm. siguro masasabi mo na around at least 60 lower, 40 upper and middle.
Aha. Pero ito po yung mga talagang mga lumad ng Quezon City o mga iba nito ay mga dayo?
Ah, hindi. Talagang mga...
Quezon City talaga po ito, ha? And then, Peter, how do I call you? Peter,
Onyx.
Anthony?
Onyx.
Ah, Onyx talaga, ha? Parang yeah. yung ano, yung mineral.
Blackstone, yeah.
Yung, okay. Bakit nga pala naging Onyx?
Oh, because of my grandmother. She likes yung mga gems.
Okay.
And because my first name is Anthony, O-N-Y.
Onyx.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And who gave, it was your grandmother
my
who gave
grandmother,
you that?
Yeah.
Okay. Ilan na ba anak niyo, Congressman?
Apat. Apat. Four children. Yeah.
How many boys, how many girls?
Four boys. The eldest is in the United States now. He's a computer engineer. The second one is a junior executive of a bank, the third one, Onyx is a city councilor of Quezon City. The fourth one just took the bar and is waiting for the results of the
yes.
bar.
And Onyx is the only one in politics?
Yes, he's the
yes.
only one.
So far?
So far.
Ibig sabihin meron pa? May darating ba?
Depends upon the people. Well, my wife is running now for
Congress. Really? Okay, okay.
Because this
siya kakahalili sa...
This is because this is my third term.
Okay.
Actually, ayaw na sana namin, but... people, the leaders there wanted a continuity of my programs, of my projects, of the help that we have been given to the poor. So they have asked me, they asked my wife to sacrifice just for one term so that there will be continuity in the projects and in the progress of, in the service of our district.
Ano pong mga proyekto ninyo na medyo matatawag natin nakabimbing pa?
Well, for example, in the high schools, I have 10 high schools sa district, no?
Okay.
Alam mo, Eric, doon sa 10, I have put 7 speech labs in 7 high schools.
Wow.
Alam mo, in speech lab is around 3 to 4 million. And it's a room full of computers. It teaches our graduates the way, how the proper way to use the English language.
Okay.
But what I'm very proud of there is, if you go around Quezon City, not only Quezon City, around the Philippines, we, in my district, is the only public high school that has a speech lab. It's the only public high school, 7 high schools. And then that be only La Salle, you know, it's expensive.
Private school.
Only La Salle.
That in itself is already, I don't know, a feather on your cap, no? Bakit speech lab po ang naisip niyo?
Well, kasi ayokong maluma yung, alam mo, tayo, 10, 15 years from now, 20 years from now, matatanda na tayo. So, as a government, elected government officials, I believe it is our duty to prepare our children. And the best way to prepare our children is to give them a weapon to fight for their future.
Education.
And that is education. And one of the education is first is English. That's why we are well known in the foreign countries, because most Filipinos speak the correct English.
Correct.
So, train natin yung mga bata sa English. Hindi lang yon, the speech lab that I got, pagka nagpasok ko ng DVD na ibang subject, kunyari biology, dun sa biology, matututo sila kasi each student has a
parang console.
Oh, console na control dun teacher.
Okay.
So, pwede silang sumagot through their console.
Onyx, what did you learn from your father? Why politics? Talagang likas sa loob mo, mamuliti ka? Kasi engineer eh. Anong klase ka bang engineer?
I'm a civil engineer, actually.
Okay.
Before starting in politics in 2010 or in public service, I actually work in a private company here in Makati. But since my dad ran for councilor since 1998, we've been behind him. So, alam namin yung mga projects niya. And as an engineer, nakita ko there are a lot of things to do in Quezon City. So, nag-usap kami ng father ko. Sabi niya, kung mapaglilingkuran natin sa city council, why not? Because he ran also for city council for two terms. And sa Quezon City nga, you can do a lot of things with your projects and programs.
But this was already behind your mind that you wanted to follow the footsteps
of
your father.
Well, I guess it was during family dinners na pag-usapan namin, but not really thinking na papasok sa public service siguro. Nagkataon lang na nagkaroon ng clamor na pwedeng maglikod. Yeah.
Oh, ganun, no? And you gave your blessings na parang, sige, go
yes,
ahead.
Yes. I believe as an engineer, he would be able to do very well for our district because madaming kailangan yung distrito namin when it comes to building, to roads.
Uh-huh.
And at least, you know, there are some powers of a councilor which the congressman does not have. For example, city ordinances. It is there. So I asked him to run in order also that our district will be properly represented in the city council.
Mas mabilis pa nga kung idadaan sa ordinances kaysa dadaan sa kongreso, no?
Yes,
correct.
Actually, sa Quezon City, for one thing, as engineer, itong 2.5 years, we actually passed a city ordinance, yung billboard ordinance.
Okay.
Yes,
because we cooperated with the MMDA since yung bagyo, nahihirapan, you know, these oversized billboards. So, Quezon City is actually the first city in Metro Manila na nakapagpasa ng billboard ordinance. So, in 1 to 2 years' time, you'll see pakonti ng pakonti yung oversized and unregulated billboards.
Any sponsored that ordinance?
Yes.
What are you strong in the council? In short, this is what you're passionate about in terms of your legislative work sa council.
Well, I don't want to limit myself to just one particular area. But for one thing, like my dad has lots of projects sa schools.
So magkatuwang kayo. Nag-uusap kayong dalawa na magtulungan
yes,
tayo dito
sa... Yes, mahirap naman na nag-aaway kami, di ba? So, meron naman kami...
Kayo. Yeah. Kaya nga magandang kombinasyon ito eh. Oo, oh, oo. Oh.
Yeah, so...
May sa schools?
Yeah, sa schools.
Yeah, one thing I admired very much, kaya nga sabi ko, I'm very happy, not because he's my son, but tama yung sabi ko, kung ano yung puno, yun ang bunga, he has performed very well. I'm very satisfied as a father. For example,
at least magkakaibigan kayo, nagtutulungan kayo. Hindi ka tulad ng iba, nag-aaway, no? May mga kasinap
for example,
nangyayaring ganun.
In all daycare centers, it's the first time. Even when I was a councilor, I never thought of it. He provided a water dispenser for all daycare centers.
Saka oral hygiene.
Saka oral hygiene. So those are his projects, which even when I was a councilor, I wasn't able to do it.
What other areas do you think you would be strong in? In short, what I'm trying to say is, pag sinabing itong proyekto nito si Onyx yan, kasi siya ang tagapatnugot yan.
Well, for one thing, siguro one accomplishment I made in the 2.5 years, may pondo naman kami. Although it's in a district development fund within the city planning, syempre bilang city councilor, pwede namin tignan ano yung pwedeng proyekto. One thing I made, we only have 2 police stations in our district, Laloma area, yung Lechon area. One more thing is sa may Masambong area. Pero hindi niya kaya i-cover yung
hindi
other
centro.
Barangays in Bahaytor. So I sponsored a project yung Baler Police Community Police Community Precinct, a 2-story precinct. So I plan to do another one, but in the far area sa Bahaytor naman, in Project 8.
Congressman, lolo na po kayo, no?
Yeah.
You're a happy grandfather.
But they do not call me lolo. My grandchildren call me daddy.
Well, walang problema yon. Ilan na po ang ano niyo, apo niyo?
4 grandchildren.
4 grandchildren. Yeah. And how many are married of the children?
5.
How many?
Five
grandchildren.
You have how many kids already?
I have one. 6 months.
Boy or girl?
Boy.
Boy.
And your wife is supportive of your political career?
Yes, she is. Yes.
Oh, that's very good. That's very good. Dito po sa pagtakbo ng inyong may bahay, pinag-usapan niyo muna.
Oh, yes, and
hindi
yes.
ho naging mahirap na kumbinsihin siyang tumakbo.
Well, nung una ayaw niya talaga. Okay. Kasi, you know, I'm not getting any younger. I'm 65, no? She's, my wife is 61. I've been serving Quezon City for 15 years. And anyway, nando naman yung anak ko. So we felt that it was time to get out and enjoy our life. Lusog pa naman ako, wala akong sakit. But, nung nagpaalam na ako that we will not run, the people, the barangay captains, the people whom we have helped, clamored that sabi nila,
inayang sila.
O paano, congressman, kung yung papalit sa'yo, lagi may sakit, nasa ospital, paano kung mapaglingkuran? Paano kung yung papalit sa'yo, congressman, igogos employee lang, yung mga kapondo, kawawa naman kami, at least kayo subuk po namin. Ano gusto niyong gawin ko? Sabi ko, last term na ako, hindi na talaga. Baka pwedeng pakausapan, misis mo na lang para tumuloy-tuloy.
At naglilibot daw ko kayo sa mga patay.
Yeah, yeah. Hindi, every time naman kahit walang election.
Pupunta kayo, ako. Tapos ano?
So,
nagpapaaral pa kayo.
So my wife, kinausap ko wife ko, nung una ayaw niya. Sabi niya, you know, I've been behind you. Siya talaga nagtatrabaho sa mga, nagpapadala ng tent, upuan sa mga patay. Siya nag-aaral kuminsan ng mga panukala sa Kongreso. Oh. Si briefs niya about it. Oh. Si practically
siya
knows.
Siya ang nagbibrief sa
inyo? Oo. Oh, yeah, si briefs niya about the committee, about the bills that are being filed. Oh, this
ano
one.
Ano ang background ng misis niyo? Kasi siya ang tatakbo itong darating.
Well,
si
Seca.
Mabuting malaman ng publiko.
She took commerce in the in the UST. She took up her commerce in UST. So, pero actually, sanay siya kasi since we were
kasi
young.
Kasi siya nasa likod din yun.
So alam niya lahat. Sabi niya, pagod na rin ako eh. Pero sabi ko, I convince her, pagbigyan na natin. O sige, nung na-convince ko, sabi niya, sige, pero one term lang ha. O di sabi ko, after that, ako na naman ang magsasakripisyo kung gusto pa ako ng tao. Sabi ko, ganon.
Pero doon sa distrito ninyo, mabibigat na ho na kalaban ninyo. Pero lahat
mukhang... like sila Vivian Tan, sila Bernard Romulo.
Ano po sikreto nung
it's not my secret, but it's the secret of the people. I am grateful to the people na ang tinitignan nila doon is the service.
Okay.
The service, the honesty, the projects, and sinasabi nila kuminsan walang utang na lubang mga tao. But in my district, they really recognize kung sino yung nakakatulong, yun ang binoboto talaga nila. That's why first term ko, I was the mayor did not back me up. Si Speaker Belmonte did not back me up.
Yan, hindi alam ng publiko yan.
Binakapan si Berna Romulo, the daughter of the executive secretary at that time.
Correct. Oh.
So it was me against the world. I was only councilor that time.
Tapos nanalo pa kayo?
I won.
Paano nanalo ang tatay mo? Baka alam mo, baka ayaw niya sabihin. Paano ba nanalo ang tatay mo?
Araw-araw, wala sa bahay. Wala. So lagi nasa distrito, umiihi sa
barangay. When I was a councilor, my life, Eric, is as a 15 years na.
Okay.
When I wake up at 10 in the morning,
okay,
I speak to people in my house up to 2. At 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
So bukas yung bahay ninyo?
Oo. I go to council or I go to congress.
Mabuti ganun kayo kasi may kilala ko ibang congressman.
Hindi, bukas.
Sasabihin doon kayo sa opisina, pumunta ko kayo dito sa bahay.
That's why it's called representative.
Uh-oh. Kaya nga, oo.
Tapos, at 2, I go to congress or at that time, the council. No? I finish at 8 in the evening, 7. At 7 in the evening, I go to the parties, birthdays, the outtaking of the people there, up to 1. At 1 o'clock, I make the rounds of all yung mga namatayan. Nakikiramay ako and help them out hanggang 6 in the morning. So, tulog sa 6 hanggang 10. Ganun na naman ang buhay ko every day for 15 years.
Now. Alam niyo, maganda ko yung relasyon ninyo sa anak ninyo. It just occurred to me, no? Kung ang Malacanang, meron tinatawag na LEDAC. Diba? I don't know, bakit hindi pwedeng gumawa ang munisipyo ng parang LEDAC between the council, the city hall, vis-a-vis their own representatives in Congress.
Yeah,
no?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. No, it may work, no?
No, in fairness to the mayor, Mayor Bistek, and to Speaker Belmonte, they have that, no?
We call it
Quezon City, meron tayong
pinagmimitigan. City Development Council.
City Development
CDC.
Council. Nandun kami lahat. All congressmen are invited.
Ah, ganun, no?
Yes,
and all NGOs are
NGOs represented. Are also invited for their suggestions on what projects. The
so it's a permanent city office?
Yeah.
For purposes of legislative.
Yeah, I think it's called once or twice a year.
Once or twice a year. It convenes once or twice a year and it hears out. The barangay captains are invited.
But can you imagine if it is in the form of a LEDAC? Where legislative initiatives, both on the city level and on a congressional level.
And the barangay level.
At barangay level. And these are all functioning together.
Yeah, it's functioning. That's what's happening.
Maganda yung ano sana, no?
Mm-hmm.
So, Congressman, your wife is coming in. Anong maipapayo nyo sa wife ninyo?
Well, he should respond to the clamor of the people to continue my services, no? Which is helping out the poor, and I think she's very keen on following up my. I had a program before, or I had a bill before, which I filed, giving out, patterned after the United States, giving out monthly to senior citizens in the entire Philippines who are not getting pension plans. Kunyari, kung wala ang pension. You're entitled to it. Kahit na mag-umpisa lang sa 500, she's very
parang
keen on that.
Parang state pension.
Yeah, state pension. Parang sa America, ganun eh, mga senior citizens. 500, maliit lang, pero umpisa
so
na yun.
So this will be a national state pension
yes,
fund?
Yes. Okay. The problem with when I filed it was that during the first reading, during the second reading, while it was in the committee, it could have been approved immediately, but what they could not determine
is
the how many will die? How many will become senior citizens? So the budget fluctuates.
There's a term for that. Sa mga pension
coming in and coming out. They don't know.
I'm not sure whether it's annuity or something.
They're studying, and it's supposed to be the DSWD that will implement it for the senior citizens.
Doon sa distrito ninyo, ano ba ang mga kailangan dyan? I'm not very much aware of the first district, but is there a need for an additional hospital? Is there a need for... Kasi these are the basic services usually na ini-introduce ng either sa council level or sa congressman. Kailangan may bagong hospital, may bagong school.
Well, actually, Quezon City has a lot of schools as well, public schools and hospitals actually. And tinedevelop na yung North Triangle, South Triangle, West Triangle.
In my district.
In our district. Actually, hindi naman kulang sa Quezon City, but I think the problem in Quezon City is that we are too large also, so kaya nga po nagkaroon ng redistricting. increase representation sa mga tao.
Okay. What can you say about, you know, the original plan of Quezon then was to make it a government district, no? The trend is it's going to become a business district. I don't know. I'm just an observer. What's your sense of it? Quezon City will become now a business center instead of a government center. Kasi, for example, yung Lang Center, parang yatang ibibid out na yata yan, ano? Or there's a new mall that's coming in. I don't know. I'm just reading the papers.
The North Triangle, which is actually located in our district, is going to be developed in the next couple of years as a central business district.
Correct. Oh.
So actually, maraming papasok na mga businesses. It's going to be patterned like yung Fort Bonifacio. So
okay.
And I think they're going to centralize yung mga hospitals dun sa isang area. Like the National Orthopedic Hospital will be transferred to that area.
Pagsasama-sama na.
Yeah.
Congressman, how do you deal yung mga ano, informal settlers? Kasi yun palagi ang problema eh.
Well, first of all, we would like to adhere to the law that there can be no relocation without a relocation site.
Okay.
Because that is the law. It was sponsored by Senator.
Pero sa government properties po ito, no?
Sa government properties, yeah.
Uh-huh.
No, in the case of, well, even in the case of the private properties, it's always the courts who will determine and will decide on when the squatters will get out, the informal settlers will get out, and I think there are some compensations being done there. As long as, in my district, when I was in the 9 years up to now, what is important to me is first, when there is a demolition, there must be no violence.
Okay.
The people's right must be respected.
Okay.
And there must be no looting.
Okay.
Because that's usually the case. No?
Marami bang informal settlers sa district?
Madami rin. Siguro around 40% are.
Mostly 30%. Are in government properties?
Yes.
May mga private properties?
Yeah. Madami rin private, pero most of them are government properties. Mm-hmm. Pero madami rin private. So, importante lang sa akin, huwag masaktan yung mga tao. Huwag manakawan. Tao.
May nakawan din.
Oh, hindi na.
Sila din ang ano, nagnanakawan.
Hindi, yung mga nagde-demolish.
Ay, yung mga
nagde-demolish.
Okay. Siguro maganda, Congressman, siguro sa term ng may bahay ninyo, misis ninyo eh, pagkapanalo nyo eh mag-file siya ng bill na those private properties that are resided upon by informal settlers, suspended muna yung pagbayad ng real estate taxes. Baka matuwa yung mga private property owners.
So.
Kasi hindi nila magamit eh.
Yes.
Diba?
Well, there are cases actually.
Diba?
There are cases
sa amin nagkakaroon ng community mortgage program, binibili yung area kapag government.
Oh.
Then, pag private din naman, I think there are cases na dinodonate nung mga private.
Oh, pwedeng ganun.
There are cases din naman, but there are also cases na they cannot stay there because in the developing area.
Pero,
what do you think of this?
That's good, ha?
Private property. Hindi mo magamit eh, pero
magamit,
pinapabayaan mo muna.
The squatters area. There's a legal problem.
Oh, pinapabayaan mo muna.
Then payment of taxes will be suspended.
Suspended muna.
I think that's a good,
kasi use of rack, hindi mo magamit yung sarili
mo. We can do that sa local LGU then.
Di ba? Para naman matuwa din yung mga...
Yes.
There is some kind of justification on both sides.
Yes.
Ano tingin niyo, Congressman?
It's a good suggestion. Yeah.
Siguro the councilor can file a bill, an ordinance with regards to that. No?
No
payment will be suspended.
Oh, in the meantime, while it is still being used by informal settlers.
Until it is settled and the owner is able to use it, then that's the only time that...
Naku, maraming matutuwa dyan.
But you know, ang mangyayari niyan, there will be... madaling palusot dyan. Kunyari, private property, magpalagay ka lang ng tao mo na informal center ni Iskatan. So, alam mo, pwedeng palusot yun.
Pwede
para hindi magbayad.
Pero yung barangay huwag yata kailangan magbantay dyan kasi hindi ba yata
hindi, kunyari, may magpa-occupy ka ng 5 families. Kausapin mo sila, siyempre, susweldo mo ba? Pero kunyari, informal settlers ka, hindi namin kayo mapalis, ha? To suspend the taxes. Yun naman ang mabigat niyan. So, it will have to be studied.
Yan ang mabigat talaga sa Pilipinas.
Magaling magpalusot.
Masyado magaling talaga
it
sa...
It will have to be studied properly in the committees before it's made into law.
Okay. Republika will pause for a few reminders. When we come back, we'll talk to the congressman and the councilor regarding their own views about what is the function of legislative work in the Congress and in terms of what do you think is the national function and the alternative function of Congress when it comes to the national policies and And of course, on the local level, we're going to see how the local politics is shaping up in Quezon City when we return.